In a world where extreme competition exists everywhere, what does it take to have success in your career and in life? Join me, Nirvana Chaudhary, as I sit down with some of the most successful individuals to discover the secrets to their success, what continues to drive them, and to hear a few exclusive stories in the process, what drives them and their success code, their mantra for making it bigger. Hello everyone, this is Nirvana Chaudhary. I'm back again with my podcast in Making It Bigger series. Nepal's known as a destination where at least everyone in the globe wants to come here once in their lifetime. 100 things to do before you die. We are known and blessed by our majestic mountains. And I guess the gods have been kind to bestow Nepal as an amazing, surreal, very naturally gifted tourism destination spot. Today I have with me Mr. Shikhar Prasai, whose family generations have been a key boulder into, key stakeholder into uplifting and changing the dynamics of the tourism industry in Nepal. Shikhar, so good to have you on our show. Before I go on to other questions, I want to really ask you is, what is it that really drives you as an entrepreneur? Someone who's taken your tourism company to greater heights. And what is your success mantra? The one success mantra that you abide by?
Thank you, Nirvan, for having me on your show. It's lovely to be here. Like you rightly said, you know, Nepal is such a beautiful country, which we have not been able to sell it well to the world. I think we need to upsell Nepal. And we have been in the business for the last more than 50 years, and I'm the second generation involved in this business. I always knew that I had to come back and work in my family business. I always like meeting people, traveling. We have got such a beautiful country, and that is what drives me, you know, to take Nepal, the tourism industry, to the next level, to how to upsell it, how to package it better and bundle it so that more and more people can come and enjoy our country. When you talk about your secret to success, I think there's nothing like hard work. You know, there's nothing like luck. You know, people say you are lucky, but I've been in the continuous journey over the last more than 20 years, and the consistent hard work will definitely prevail, and then you'll come out a winner.
Absolutely true to his word. You know, I've seen Shikhar over the last two decades, I think, consistently focused and been working so hard into taking his company and organization and strengthening the tourism of Nepal. Now, Shikhar, I think one of the industries we all know has been most hard hit is tourism. And Nepal, whose economy, tourism, contributes a major chunk. You as industry leader, you as someone who's been driving your company, last 1.5 years would have been very, very challenging for you. What are some of the values and traits that you told your team, told yourself, told the people around you to stay ahead, to stay afloat, and to stay alive during this time?
Yes, we have been going through a very challenging period, and to have to say that, Nirvan, like, I joined the industry in 1999, and that was immediately when I joined. We had this Maoist problem. There was a challenge, ups and downs, and business was not good. Tourism, it's a very sensitive business. We had the earthquake, again now this. So we had a share of uneventful events which were beyond our control. So what I believed is, like, in the initial days, like, I thought, like, this is a break for me. Stay out of the business and try to think, and how can you come back again? So that really helped me, and now I'm working towards other parts of the things which I had never given time on. So we're trying to work on a new venture which will come out in the next few months, and to not lose hope. You see, even if you see a tree as an example, it loses its leaves and everything, but if you wait and in the next season, the leaves come back again. So I see there's a light at the end of the tunnel. It's a matter of time, not losing hope, continuously trying and trying to evolve and be creative. So these are things that what I've been working on, and it's keeping me busy.
Shikhar, like I mentioned, someone who's very resilient, seen the industry go up and down, but still managing and taking his industry and his company forward, adapting, being agile, continuously coming up with different ideas, etc. Shikhar, you know, I'm a big fan of Bhutan, right? And they've been able to really strategize their niche upmarket tourism really well. And whenever I go to Bhutan, you know, the people always there telling me, you know, we're looking at Nepal, how your tourism is shaping up, how you guys are strategizing, and we learn from that and then take Bhutan's direction forward. Do you think there's a lot we can learn from Bhutan, or what is the opportunity we can pursue in Nepal for, you know, really bringing in the niche upmarket tourism and tourists that exist?
No, definitely, like what you rightly said, you know, there are many countries which have learned from Nepal. If you talk about the national parks, even the Indian tourism operators used to come and see how our national parks were run, and then they went ahead and now they're way ahead. Like you rightly said about Bhutan, Bhutan comes and looks into us and see. And I think they had a very good learning, you know. They went for quality versus quantity, and they are achieving that. So the Nepal tourism policy has to be re-looked and see like how we can invite high-paying clients and sell Nepal at the right price. I feel that we are selling at a very low price and keeping ourselves low. So we need to seriously work on ideas and innovations to keep us on the next level, to take us to the next level.
You know, they always say that life is like a grinding stone. It either wears you down or polishes you up, depending on what you are made up of. And I guess this constant every half a decade, or these unexpected calamities and catastrophes that come and hit you, and you're still able to go on top over a period of time through your resilience, is I think what makes a good leader and an entrepreneur. Now, Shikhar, you know, majority of our youth workforce, we have over 50% of our population that's below the age of 21. We have 70% of our population that's below the age of 35. In South Asia's context, almost 100,000 people are joining the workforce every day, right? In Nepal's context, we have the tourism, which has been bestowed naturally to us. We have the uncertain times. Are you as an individual still hell-bent on the potential and prospects of tourism, or you as a entrepreneur looking at diversifying into other opportunities? And how do you really assess a situation like that?
No, I'll be honest with you, there were times when I thought like I should diversify into some things, but to be honest, that was only for a short period of time. So like now today, I'm more focused on trying to build things on tourism, work on tourism, spend my rest of the life that I have on tourism and taking it forward. You know, it has given me time to think, relook and get back. And this time has been really important to work on new projects and new ideas to take tourism to a different level. I will work on this prospect. It's an immense opportunity. There's a lot of scalability in the industry. And I think we should all work towards getting tourism into the next level.
Thank you so much, Shikhar. On a completely different note, you know, whenever I see this movie, Three Idiots, right? And I see this character, Phansuk Wangdu, and I see him say, all is well, I always somehow think of you doing that, right? We know today people are just going crazy, just chasing money so much and missing out on probably some of the most simplest, yes, some of the most fundamentals in life, right? They're chasing something else. What is your views and what is your message to them lastly?
What I feel is like I like to keep my life simple. And even during these difficult times, I did manage to spend a lot of family time with my kids, my spouse, you know, cooking with them, traveling with them, learning with them, playing with them. So that keeps me happy, you know. So I try and keep my things simple. And even with my kids, like what I tell them is the most important thing in life is to be a good human being. You know, be kind, be empathetic, take care of people who are not able to take care of themselves, and to give. So these are things I tell my kids, and I practice it as well. And I involve them in things when I'm giving. I involve them and let them know how things work and what are the things we need to do. So these things really help me out, you know. And I tell my kids and the other people that you're asking me to share what my views are is, you have to be agile, you have to be adaptive, you know. Life is a continuous learning process. And you have to fail fast, learn quick, and move ahead. Continuously keep trying out, never give up.
Thank you so much, Shikhar. It's always such an amazing experience for me. I get to learn so much after hearing you talk about your experience. A good work-life family balance. And very important thing that I picked up from our conversation was really involving the next generation, your kids, into doing good. Making them do that through practice and in reality. Thank you so much, Shikhar, for taking our time for this podcast. And I hope in due course, you will be making it bigger.
Thank you, Nirvan, for having me with you. It was a pleasure being with you. Thank you.